This video is sponsored by Envato Elements. You'll have access to over 55 million assets such as fonts, photos, video templates, WordPress themes, and Adobe templates, all with commercial licenses for extra peace of mind. They offer a nice simple license, and your licenses will still count even after your subscription has ended. Get unlimited downloads with Envato Elements. Follow the link in the description to get 50% off with an annual subscription. It's the only source you'll ever need. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a classic horror movie poster that includes words carved into a human skull. I provided this image of a human skull so you could follow along. Its link is in my video's description or project files. I'll be using two fonts in this video, which I included their links as well. One is called Another Danger, which I downloaded from Envato Elements, and the other is called Chiller, which I downloaded from FontZone. Feel free to use any fonts you like. In addition, I provided a set of custom brushes that we'll use to envelop our skull in smoke. That brush set is called Explosion Brushes. Before we begin, smash that subscribe button to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. And remember to click like if you like this video. The first step is to convert the skull into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Surface Blur. Basically, surface blur blurs an image while preserving its edges. The radius specifies the size of the area sampled for the blur, while the threshold determines the amount of blur. Make the radius and the threshold both 20. Next, we'll make a displacement map, which we'll use to make our text look as if it's wrapping itself around the contours of the skull. Before we do, let's collapse the smart filter to save some space in the Layers panel. Make the skull active, and click the icon at the upper right. Click Duplicate Layer. Open the Destination Document list and click New. Type in Displacement. Notice we now have a new document named Displacement. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 3 pixels. Go to File, and Save As. Save it to your desktop for quick access as a Photoshop PSD file and click Save. If you see this message, just click OK. Now that we saved our displacement map, we can close it. Open your horizontal type tool and type Picker. Pick a font to use over the skull. I'm using Chiller Regular. I'll make its size 16 points, smooth, and center alignment. If the color box isn't white, click it, and when the color picker opens, pick white. Go to a corner and drag your tool to the opposite corner. Go to Window and Character to open the character panel. Place your cursor over the scrubby slider of the tracking icon and drag it to the left or right to adjust the amount of space between the characters. Drag the scrubby slider over the leading icon to increase or decrease the amount of space between the lines of type. Type out your text. To fill the text box with your text, highlight your text and press Ctrl or Command C to copy it. Click at the end of your last character and press Ctrl or Command V repeatedly to paste in your text until it fills the text box. Then press Enter or Return. We can close the character panel now. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Distort, and Displace. Make the horizontal and vertical scales 20 each, stretch to fit, and repeat edge pixels. Navigate to your desktop click the displacement document you saved earlier, and click Open. Change the blend mode to color dodge, and reduce its opacity to 70%. Make the skull active, and make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Change the copy's blend mode to linear burn. Scroll to the top and make the text layer active. Name it Text Over Skull. Collapse the smart filter to save some space, and double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is emboss, the technique is chisel hard, and the depth is 250%. The direction is down, the size is 2 pixels, and soften it 4 pixels. The angle and altitude are 5 degrees each, and the gloss contour is linear. The highlight mode is irrelevant since its opacity is 0%. The shadow mode is linear burn, the color is black, and its opacity is 100%. Collapse the effects. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Hue Saturation. Check Colorize. The hue is 0, the saturation is 60, and the lightness is 0. Click the new layer icon and name it Smoke. Click the foreground color and pick a rich bright red. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Assuming you installed the brush set I provided, scroll to the bottom and you should see the Explosion Brushes folder. Open it and feel free to experiment to see which brush you like. For my image, I'll use 0010 Explosion. We'll adjust its size in a moment. If you want to rotate the brush, you could either rotate the arrow on the dial or press the right or left arrow key on your keyboard. Open the brush picker again and either slide the size or type in an amount. For this brush, I'll type in 3,000 pixels. Position it over your image and click once. If you want to move it up or down, press V to open your Move tool and press and hold the Shift key as you drag it up or down. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Open your Horizontal Type tool and type Picker. Pick a font for the title of your poster. I'm using Another Danger Regular from Envato Elements. I'll make its size 56 points. Click on your document and type out your text. If you want to adjust the tracking, another way to do it is to highlight all your text and press Alt or Option and the right or left arrow key on your keyboard. To adjust the space between just two characters, place your cursor between those characters and press the same hotkeys. To adjust its overall size, highlight it and drag the size scrubby slider. To reposition it, open your Move tool and drag it. Next, we'll warp some of the characters to make them look more sinister. First, convert your text into a smart object and go to Filter and Liquify. Make the density and pressure 100 each. Make sure the Forward Warp tool is active. This pushes the pixels forward as you drag it. To adjust its size, make sure your caps lock key is off and press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Drag the ends of your text to extend them. Then click OK. Collapse the smart filter and make a copy of your text. Make the original text layer active and go to Filter, Blur, and Radial Blur. Make the amount 100 and make the blur method Zoom and the quality Best. Drag the blur center to the top middle. Next, we'll mask out the blur above the characters, but before we do, reduce its opacity to 80%. Shift-click the top text to make it active as well, and press Ctrl or Command G to place them into a folder. Name it Top Text. Open the folder and open the original text's filter. Make the filter's layer mask active. With your brush tool active, brush above the characters to mask out the blur. Make the top text active and right-click the layer to open the flyout list. Click New Smart Object via Copy. This creates an independent copy of the smart object, which allows us to change it without affecting its source. This new copy will become the text that we place at the bottom of the poster. Drag the new copy above the folder and double-click the thumbnail to open its source. Double-click the large T of the text layer to highlight the text and type in your new text. If your text extends beyond the boundaries, we'll reduce its size to fit it all inside. Highlight the text and drag the scrubby slider to the left. Then adjust the character's spacing. Once you're happy with the spacing, highlight the text again and increase its size to fill the shape. Open your Move tool and center it. Then close the updated text. When you see this message, click Yes to save the changes. Name it Bottom Text. Open the Smart Filter and delete Liquify by dragging it to the trash. Make a copy of the layer and make the original bottom text active. Apply the last filter we used by pressing Ctrl-Alt-F on Windows or Command-Ctrl-F on a Mac. Then press Enter or Return. Shift-click the top text and place them into a folder. Name it Bottom Text. With your Move tool active, press and hold the Shift key as you drag it straight down. Open the Bottom Text folder and make the bottom text layer mask active. Open back the brush tool and brush above the characters to mask out the blur. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.